All right, it's that time again. You guys ready? My name is Doreen. I'm a gigantic nerd, and for about 8 months now, I've been searching for the best Spider-Man VR game. In the first video, I said this game was bad and this one was good. Then in the next video, I said that game was bad again, and then said this one was good. Then absolutely nothing happened. And then there's us talking now. There you go, you're up to speed. But in those 5 months, I was researching, playing, going back on things I'd said, and murdering countless amounts of people, all in the search for the best Spider-Man VR mod. And thanks to your comments, I've found my challenges. The Blade and Sorcery Lashing mod. And the Boneworks Spider-Man mod. Two modifications translating my dreams into VR. What they have in common is combat, like covered in part 2, but where they differ is in their ways of execution. Join me as we discover which will reign supreme. This is the hunt for the best Spider-Man VR mod. My journey began in humanity's center of intelligence and wisdom. From the moment I uploaded part 1, you guys have been suggesting games for me to play. Looking through these comments, there's certain ones that pop up more than others. There was a certain suggestion, a mod, that I saw so much it honestly annoyed me. So I did what any sane person would do and said something that I'm about to go back on. Twice. Let me just remind you that this is the hunt for the best Spider-Man VR game, not the best Spider-Man VR mod. Now, trust me, I wouldn't be making this video unless I genuinely cared about this game and this mod. I've been playing it for a couple weeks now, and I can honestly say that its combat far surpasses anything covered in part 2. The Spider-Man-ness of the combat is simply unmatched. And guess what? I ran it, and my computer didn't explode. Just in case you somehow didn't know, Boneworks is a pretty big deal in the VR space. It's one of the platform's flagship games, boasting a full-on physics system that innovates in a similar way to Half-Life 2's. With its implementation, mechanics from many different games are either automatically in or have the perfect foundations to be built upon. It's no lie that Boneworks has one of the best hand-to-hand combat systems out there, and it's the perfect stage for a spider. Being what is basically the Garry's Mod of virtual reality, Boneworks has a thriving modding community. It's made up of the same galaxy brain bastards that somehow managed to put multiplayer into a single-player game. How? The place you can find all of these mods is in the Thunderstore page for the game. Here you'll be able to find all of the add-ons we'll be discussing today. The most important one, though, is the Spider-Man mod. This one is probably one of the most highly coveted mods on the scene. It's definitely most popular, as I'm told by its presence on the most downloaded tab on the store. After watching a video or two and then pressing some buttons, I was ready to play. Right, so you remember how I thought Boneworks was going to totally kill my computer? Well, it might not have done that exactly, but that doesn't necessarily mean I can run it well. Outside of this depressing black box environment, I mostly get terrible frame rates. At the very least, from my experience, the Spider-Man mod doesn't seem to make your performance any worse. That being said, if you do happen to have a NASA Quantum computer lying around, you can also download custom maps from the Thunderstore, with plenty of city environments to boot. But enough rambling, let's get into the meatloaf and potatoes. To begin with, you can outfit yourself in a couple of Spider-Man's different looks by taking advantage of the custom player models available on the Thunderstore. One of them is even a model ripped directly from Marvel Powers United, a long-forsaken Spider-Man VR game we'll probably never get to play again. Please bring it back. Please?
Miss Brandt?
Yes?
Get me a violin!
The Spider-Man mod itself adds a fair few of Spider-Man's powers to the Boneworks sandbox. If you whip open this nifty little menu, you'll actually be able to customize all of these options too. You've also got a very much appreciated super jump. Like, it's such a simple thing, but for some reason only like two of the other games I've covered have it. So kudos to you, devs. Another underutilized spider ability is wall crawling, which is present here. This I can see not having all that much practicality in combat, but definitely in the main campaign or just traversal in general. But the main thing we're here for is the webs, and especially how they are in combat. By double pressing the trigger or grip buttons, or any other input you opt for since you can change it, you can shoot out a web. Playing the iconic Raimi web noise, you can use these webs to swing around or for more deadly use cases. I honestly find the swinging in the Spider-Man mod to just be okay. With the Boneworks physics engine, I kind of went in with the expectation that it would be really good, but it feels kind of clunky compared to other games I've played. I think it comes down to how it controls. From the get-go, the webs feel more like grapples than pendulums, similar to Far From Home VR, but a little bit more egregious. You can't yank yourself around like in Gumball, so that doesn't help either. What this does is basically lock you into moving in the direction you were facing when you shot your web and not much else. It makes for a pretty disappointing web swinging system, at least for me. The other main function of the webs are as physics objects that can act upon other physics objects. In this case, the grapple physics can actually be pretty handy, since you can pull objects towards you that are out of your force grab range. On the downside, you can't shoot them out and climb on them, like in the silkworm, for example. The area the webs succeed the most in has got to be combat. Add in your physics-enabled body, and there's no limit to the amount of ways you can dispatch hordes of fords or null bodies. If you want to get fancy with it, you can web an enemy's face and then slam them into the ground, or even do this little jump and web thing I love doing. What I love the most has definitely got to be the hand-to-hand combat, simply for the reason that it's new after being sorely needed. While the other games had Spider-Man combat, they had you going up against some assortment of robots or flying creatures. What I really wanted to do was go head-to-head with some humanoid enemies, so I can feel like I'm clearing a room full of goons on my way to fight a supervillain. That feeling is exactly what the Boneworks Spider-Man mod gives me. All I've got to do is whip out the utility guns, spawn in some enemies, and I'm ready to serve some cold hands. But what makes it even better still is the addition of slow motion. I know it's technically a feature from the base game and not the mod, but just pretend it's spider sense or something. Just don't think too hard about it. God, I wish I could tell you with words how fun it is to fight these guys in slow motion. With the increased reaction time and the addition of all the other mechanics we've just covered, it makes for an absolute blast. The only complaint I really have outside of the swinging is how when you use the super strength to lift up an enemy, throwing them down causes you to fly into the air. This is likely just a little physics goof, but it can get really, really annoying. Other than that, the fundamentals are passable, even if the performance is bad. Once again, I didn't throw up, and that's all I care about. But before we wrap this up, I just have to mention this. If you're at all in tune with the VR scene, then you probably know that the successor to Boneworks, Bonelab, was just announced. This has sent ripples through the community, because all of these amazing physics systems will be ported to the Quest 2, so that dozens of others can enjoy them. Judging by the trailer we got, it's looking like modding will be a focus of the game. My personal hope is that whoever made this mod can port it to the Quest 2, because, my god, this will be amazing untethered and at a more stable frame rate. But anyway, the Boneworks Spider-Man mod can be kind of disappointing on the web-swinging front, with its controls and physics leaving something to be desired, but where its punches hit hardest is in combat, giving you a rich set of spider skills and letting you dispose of your foes in any way imaginable. Well, there you go, there's another thing I've said in the past and then contradicted in the present. I'll take it off the list. For our next game, we'll be traveling into the deepest depths of my homicidal instincts. Better grab a sword.
Welcome back. Fortnite is the latest video game kids can't get enough of.
You know, I'm actually quite surprised that Tracy Grimshaw hasn't lambasted this game in A Current Affair yet, since it's literally the most violent thing humanity has ever created. But being the secretly psychopathic baboons that we are, this game also happens to be one of the most famous VR games of all time. With dozens of videos with millions of views covering it, it's certainly made its mark on the industry. And on our now blood-soaked hands, like I literally just smell pennies talking about it. Of course, once something gets popular enough, people are going to want to see one of the most famous characters ever conceived crossover with it in some way. And it's for that reason that we're here today. Time to set aside all feelings of empathy. We're talking about Blade and Sorcery. Blade and Sorcery and Boneworks share a lot of common ground. The most obvious ground they both stand on is that the two share a fully integrated physics engine. However, where they differ is that Blade and Sorcery is set in a fantasy world where you can shoot fireballs out of your hands and stuff. In the game, you can jump into an arena of your choosing and then can spawn a variety of different melee weapons. You then let out all of the anger you've had pent up ever since they announced a Kraven solo movie instead of saving him for the college trilogy. As you can imagine, the results are particularly gruesome. If you want to get old-fashioned with it, you can just whip out your hands and beat the life out of someone. Blade and Sorcery also iterates on Boneworks with the addition of a kick button, something so simple yet so fun. Just like its competition, this game has a huge modding scene hosted on Nexus Mods. Most of the add-ons you'll find are quality of life changes, extra weapons, or the ability to Captain Carter people, but what we're interested in is the Lashing mod. Installation was pretty run-of-the-mill, just download a file, just extract to desktop, you know, blah blah blah. After jumping in and playing around with the lashes, I was surprised at just how versatile they are. To begin with, lashes can both be used in combat and for other utilities, like swinging and moving objects. The swinging is actually a lot better than I anticipated it would be. It feels really speedy, and you can switch the way they work on the fly, going from a pendulum to a grapple with a literal press of a button. The way it works is by holding the grip and trigger, you'll shoot out a lash that immediately flings you in the direction you shot it. You can then release the trigger to stop retracting the lash, switching to a pendulum mode, or continue to retract it like a grapple. If you want, you can even hold down the spell wheel button to extend the lash back out. This system is actually the most accurate Spider-Man webbing I've ever experienced so far, since we see Spider-Man retract and extend his webs like this dozens of times in the comics, shows, and movies. But though it can be fun, the maps just aren't made with web swinging in mind. I definitely recommend the map with the big bridge in the middle, since that one is the most open and probably the easiest for swinging. The only thing really holding the swinging back is how the crosshair for the web, seen here, snaps to certain locations in the environment instead of you just being able to shoot them anywhere. This actually does come in handy with something I'll discuss in a minute, but here it makes you feel a little bit more restricted. You also don't have a super jump either. You can probably mod this in, but we're just exclusively looking at the lashing mod today. But enough whinging, let's talk about the cool stuff. Something this mod has in common with the silkworm is that your webs are actual objects that stay around after you've shot them. This unlocks a bunch of possible applications. You can pull objects and weapons towards you, or web certain obstacles together or out of your way. You can sling them across gaps and then climb along them, or you could even imbue a weapon with lashing and then cut the rope, turning it into a grapple. But where all of these different applications come together is in the combat, and holy crap, is it brutal. With the power of the lashing mod, there are so many different things you can do to get yourself on a watch list. Some of my favorites include disarming enemies, crucifying them, webbing them up to high places and watching them hang. It's like if Spider-Man was in a Netflix Marvel show. Combine your webs with the viscerally satisfying melee combat and you've got something special. Another thing that Blade and Sorcery has in common with Boneworks is the slow motion, the pseudo spider sense I was talking about. Something it does differently though is making you about as strong as Superman while you're using it. This lets you straight up send people to God physically and then again spiritually once they hit the ground. You could even use somebody's, well, body as a flail like I did here. Just swept him off his feet. With feet. Also, the combat is actually made easier by something I didn't like from before. The web snapping to certain things can be a total pain with swinging, but in combat it's more than welcome. It streamlines aiming so you don't have to spend so much time lining up your shots. This mod also adds in these lashing bombs that can be thrown down. After a few seconds and some satisfying sound design, everything within a 5-meter radius will get stuck together. If you want to make someone's death as painful as possible, lash them to the ground, throw some daggers around, and then throw one of these puppies down. Hey there, government agent. Listen, I promise I'm not a serial killer in the making, okay? Just don't put me within 50 meters of Aviarad, and we'll all be just fine. I'm happy to say that the lashing mod isn't any more buggy than Blade and Sorcery already is, meaning that it's totally jank, but in a fun way. A bug I did encounter was people getting stuck into the ground and bugging out Source Engine style, or just flying away when I walk up to them. I mean, come on, I'm not that ugly. Like, am I?
Yes.
As I said before, the sound design is pretty cool. It kinda reminds me of the Infinity Gauntlet with its deep hums and rumbles. On top of that, the whole look of the mod feels distinctly fantasy, with the wispy purple lashes looking like something out of Doctor Strange. The only exception to this is the lashing bombs, which take on a slightly more futuristic sort of look. Although a little bit different from the typical Spider-Man style, it's a welcome change. Now, you've probably noticed from watching the gameplay in the background right now that my graphic settings aren't very high. That's because I'm one of those psychos who puts a stable frame rate over anything else, and while I can't exactly say that's what I get, I can definitely say the lashing mod doesn't make it any worse. Since the game is capable of running on Quest, if you've got a decent PC and you just turn down the settings a little bit, you should be able to get at least 60 FPS while there's enemies on screen. And as for Nomad players, the mod isn't even on there, but it might be in the future. We don't know.
For sure.
At the end of the day, the Blade and Sorcery lashing mod is a chock-full addition to an already existing sandbox. It offers a wide range of applications, from high-octane swinging to high-body-count combat, and although certain things hold it back from being a true Spider-Man experience, it offers you combat that pleases you as much as it pains your enemies. I'm going to introduce something I've never done in a Spider-Man VR Hunt video before. In the past, when I've decided which is the best of any set of games I'm covering, I usually make the decision based on my personal opinion and then back it up with a little bit of reasoning. That's what I was going to do before beginning to script out this video, but after seeing how close these games are in terms of mechanics and Spider-Man offerings, I'm instead going to change it up. This time we'll be using a points system. Utilizing all of the knowledge we have about these two mods, we're going to compare them and then award them with up to 10 points in the following 5 categories. Swinging. How good is the mod's web swinging? Are you able to control it well? Combat. How diverse are the combat offerings? What does the mod introduce that complements combat? Versatility. How much can you actually do with the mod? Does the mod add anything else besides webs? Replayability. What draws you back in after an initial play? What parts of the mod aren't replayable? Fun factor. How fun is it to play? Alright, the time has finally come. It's time to decide the best Spider-Man VR mod. I think the swinging from the Boneworks Spider-Man mod honestly leaves a lot to desire. Although it does feel fast, it doesn't feel anywhere near as fast as what the Blade and Sorcery Lashing mod offers. The restriction of the physics being grapple-based certainly doesn't help. On top of that, the controls constantly send me in the wrong direction. In the Lashing mod, I feel as though I have way more control, since I can shoot out a lash and it'll immediately pull me in that direction. Boneworks does allow you to customize the webs a bit, but I mostly found this to be trivial. On the other hand, the Lashing mod allows you to switch between grapple and pendulum physics on the fly, and even telescope your lashes. This makes for the most accurate Spider-Man webbing I've ever seen. The only thing that holds it back is the crosshair lock-on, which, while it may be beneficial in later categories, it definitely restricts it here. For its losses in the field of control and overall replication of the web-swinging fantasy, the Boneworks Spider-Man mod gets a 6 out of 10. And for its mostly masterful and intricate recreating of one of the most iconic superhero abilities, the Lashing mod gets a 9 out of 10. Both games are on a largely equal playing field in terms of combat. The two have a physics system that works in tandem perfectly with the combat mechanics. In both games, you can square up with dozens of enemies in guttural hand-to-hand combat. Webs also play a unique role in both. In Boneworks, they can be used to pull enemies together, towards you, or even into the ground. The added ability to super jump also enables a satisfying verticality and gravity to combat. On the other hand, the Lashing mod provides for the same brutal hand-to-hand combat, but where it lacks a super jump, it makes up for with a kick button that you can do multiple cool attacks with. Your webs can also disarm enemies, stick them to surfaces, or throw them in any direction you like. Overall, most things you can do in the Boneworks mod you can do in the Lashing mod, save for the jump takedown. Both games also have a slow motion option that knocks some spider sense into you. The only difference is that Blade and Sorceries gives you an insane strength that is probably accurate to Spider-Man's if he didn't hold back. A key difference between them though is that Boneworks gives you spider strength outside of slow motion, allowing you to hold enemies directly above your head or even throw them into others. Boneworks also allows you to use guns and Blade and Sorcery melee weapons. In what is likely the tightest category so far, the Boneworks Spider-Man mod gets a 9 for a well-done power fantasy that offers verticality and extreme strength. Meanwhile, the Lashing mod gets an 8 out of 10 for having versatile web integrations but lacking some key Spider-Man attributes. In this category, both games have their perks. In the Lashing mod, your webs exist after you've shot them. This can be used to web things out of the way, web enemies to surfaces, or even function as ropes across gaps in terrain. But in the Boneworks mod, your webs don't possess these traits, leading them to feel more like a retracting rope. A plus is that the Boneworks mod adds wall crawling, which certainly has its applications. It also allows you to switch to a Spider-Man avatar, helping to sell the fantasy. On the Blade and Sorcery end, Lashing Bombs and Glue Mode are added as fun bonuses. They function almost like gadgets that Spidey might have on hands, and they remind me of similar gameplay mechanics from Superfly. Both games allow you to use your webs as a sort of get-over-here tool when your assorted force grabs might be out of range, but Boneworks' feels a lot more usable. Though it may appear the Blade and Sorcery wins here, I've found that the mod's extra additions are a bit one-note. They're cool, but once you've used them enough times, they kind of get old. You can only really use them in the most obvious way, which holds them back from being great. Whereas with Boneworks, I haven't even changed my avatar back to Arthur after I installed the Spider-Man ones, and having the ability to wall crawl completely changes how you play the game. The Lashing mod slips a little bit in this category, with its somewhat surface level additions being made up for by its silkworm-like web mechanics, earning it a 7 out of 10. The Boneworks Spider-Man mod triumphs with additions that, while lesser in quantity, are literally game-changing, earning it a 9 out of 10. Surprisingly enough, my opinion on which of these mods is more replayable has shifted quite a bit. One thing I am sure of is that my experiences in the Lashing mod can often become a loop. I'll disarm the enemies with my webs, then go into slow motion and either punch, kick, or stab them. Then I'll either slam them into a ground or web them into a pole or something. Even though I listed off a bunch of things you could do, that doesn't mean they're very practical. That human flail thing especially is tricky. The one clip I showed you before is genuinely the only clip I have of it. On the other side, the Boneworks mod feels a lot more replayable simply because the mechanics are just that tight. I have like 20 minutes of footage of me just doing the jump takedown thing because it just feels so good. and it's easy, so it's practical in actual combat. Something that's a little bit amusing is that ever since I started writing this video, I've been playing Blade and Sorcery more, but not the Lashing mod, just using melee weapons. Overall, the Lashing mod gives you a lot to do, but once you've actually done all of those things once or twice, they lose their flair, whereas the Boneworks mod does less, but better and more consistently. For replayability, the Boneworks mod gets an 8 out of 10, and the Lashing mod a 6. Here we are at the final category. Right now, Boneworks leads with 32 points, and Blade and Sorcery sits at 30. The winner shall be decided soon. Are you ready? Here we go. Both of these games are pretty fun. I feel like replayability has a lot to do with fun factor, since you wouldn't be replaying the game if it wasn't fun. With that being said, though the Lashing mod isn't as replayable as the Boneworks mod, it's always fun to punt an enemy into the sky or faceplant them into the sand. While other things might get old, that certainly doesn't. Boneworks offers such a similar experience overall that it's kind of hard to award these final points. But the decision has to be made, and so I award the Boneworks Spider-Man mod a 7 out of 10 for fun factor. The main thing holding it back here, aside from nitpicks, is a lackluster swinging system. If it was better, it easily would have gotten a 9 out of 10. Finally, for the Lashing mod's poignant yet grating combat and expansive web swinging, I award it an 8 out of 10. Placing it 1 point below its competitor. Which means that the title of the best Spider-Man VR mod goes to Boneworks. I've got to admit, the main thing that won me over with the Boneworks mod was just how Spider-Man-y it is. As you obviously saw though, it was an extremely tight competition. Well done to both, but the Boneworks Spider-Man mod will now bear the crown. And that brings us to the end of our Spider-Man VR mod hunt journey. Thank you all so much for watching and for joining me today, seriously. I'm really sorry that it's taken me this long to make another mini doc. 5 months is a long time on YouTube, and truth be told, I took that long because I was scared. Scared that whatever I put out could never match my 1 million view crown jewel. But the fact that we're here, right now, proves that you can always overcome fear. If you didn't know that before, I hope you do now. But despite that, there's still something I want to address. The Spider-Man VR Hunt Part 3. It's my most anticipated video ever, and that can be pretty scary. But I'm not afraid. I have a dream that I want to bring to life, and when you have a dream, don't ever be afraid. So stand up, true believer. You've got this.